dear representatives, presidents, kings, and highnesses. It's my pleasure to introduce you the representative members of Lebanon. Would you please clap for them?
Honorable Chair, esteemed delegate, you are honored to preside our country Lebanon at this meeting. Lebanon is a small rural country on the east coast of the Mediterranean Sea. We came to comfort time to return at the crossroads of the three countries, Asia, Europe, and Africa. It is a sizable and highly desired territory. Throughout the history, it has been the stage for conflict between the local world, the local white people, and the world south. After being ruled by the Ottoman Empire and the Israel, Lebanon gained full independence in 1943. The presence of Palestinian refugees and the royal basis and tensions between Christian and Muslim have led to continued political instability and warfare in recent decades. However, the Lebanese people have continued to survive in the face of the disruption of the economy and day-to-day life. From 1975 until 1991, civil war ruined Lebanon. Since early 1990s, the Lebanese government regained some power, but there are still incidents of political violence, especially near the south, near Aqaba. Now, Honorable Fayyad, Mohammed Fayyad, will present the problem.
Honorable Chair, esteemed delegates, I'm going to present the electricity problem in Lebanon. The electricity problem in Lebanon is a governmental issue that has been a major obstacle for all the Lebanese people since years. The problem is a financial one that requires a lot of money to afford all of you need to light up all the street domestic lights. It's also due to the mismanagement in the electricity sector and bribery of debt among all people. Now my colleague Ibrahim Hashim is going to present the other problem of Lebanon.
Honorable Chair, esteemed delegates, Beirut and non-Lebanon are facing severe garbage crisis. After the closure of Burj Mahmoud dump site in 1997, the Al Nami dump site was opened by our government in 1998. The Al Nami dump site was planned to contain 2 million tons of waste for a limited period of 6 years at most. 16 years later, Al Nami dump site was still open, exceeding its full capacity by reaching 13 million tons. In July 2015, the residents of the area already protesting in the recent forced closure of the dump site. Furthermore, I apologize for the inefficiency of our government as well as the corruption inside of the waste management supply of the waste companies to clean by unable to be managing the waste that are blocking the streets. Now, my colleague Laila Sreddin will be talking about the solutions.
Honorable Chair, esteemed delegates, in any problem, there are so many solutions. The first solution for the electricity problem is to establish new thermal power plants or build more factories for the electricity. And also we can immediate exchange of diesel oil by natural gas for operating the thermal power plants, or by rehabilitation of existing power plants in Jinhae and Zouk. Also, the second solution for the garbage problem is to build more factories and buy motor machines for recycling the garbage, or by using incineration, for example, by burning garbage in fields that are far from people, or by exporting the garbage outside the country. I wish a fruitful debate to debate here, and I'm glad to say that Lebanon is honored to be at this meeting. Thank you.